Hello and welcome to the How Do I series for Microsoft Dynamics NAV. My name is Jared Conroy and I am a Microsoft Dynamics NAV escalation engineer. In this video, I will present How Do I automate provisioning of Dynamics NAV 2013 on a Windows Azure virtual machine. At the end of this video, you will know how to run a Windows PowerShell script which automates the provisioning of a new instance of Dynamics NAV 2013 on a single Windows Azure virtual machine. The assumption is made that viewers have already prepared their PC with the necessary tools in order to deploy NAV on Azure using the PowerShell ISE environment. For details about how to prepare your machine, see my previous video titled How Do I Get Started with Provisioning Tools for Windows Azure. The objectives of this video are to become familiar with key sample PowerShell scripts, to create and adjust your customized parameter file, to create your first NAV on Azure virtual machine, and starting the web client and the Windows client on your newly deployed NAV on Azure virtual machine. The steps we will be following throughout this video include Step 1, reviewing the sample PowerShell scripts. Step 2, customizing the parameter file. Step 3, creating a NAV on Azure virtual machine. And Step 4, accessing Dynamics NAV on the Azure virtual machine. When you are preparing your machine to work with the provisioning tools for Azure, one of the steps included copying NAV provisioning tools from the cloud folder in the Dynamics NAV installation media to your PC. See step 3 in my previous video, How Do I Get Started with Provisioning Tools for Azure, for further details about this. To review the sample PowerShell scripts, we will open the Windows PowerShell ISE environment. When opening the PowerShell ISE, be sure to run as administrator. This is the location where I have placed the NAV provisioning tools on my machine. There are two PowerShell sample script files which are vital for automating provisioning of Dynamics NAV on a Windows Azure virtual machine. This file contains all of the parameter values which you will need to specify in order to customize the provisioning process for your requirements. Later in this video, we will be making a copy of this file and updating all of the relevant settings in order to create a single machine deployment for NAV on Azure. This is the main PowerShell script which we will be running in order to provision a NAV on Azure single machine instance. Next, we need to make a copy of the set_partner_settings.ps1 script file, and we must name the copy set_partner_settings-custom.ps1, as this file name is referenced elsewhere in the provisioning process. In the copied file, we can specify the custom values we want to use for our NAV on Azure instance. When we run the provisioning process to create our NAV on Azure instance, this file name will be included along with any parameter settings we configure inside it. We will need to configure several of these settings so that the NAV on Azure instance will be created according to our requirements. Specifically, we need to uncomment and remove the to-do tag.